In the last century, the Earth's average temperature has risen by 1 degree, changing the planet's climate and disrupting the weather. An estimated 300,000 deaths have been caused by climate change. Just a slight change in the temperature led to this tragedy. Experts say that 40% of the living creatures on Earth will become extinct if average temperatures rise by 2%. If temperatures rise by more than 2%, there will be massive floods that would displace 70 million people. The planet's ecosystem will collapse if temperatures increase by 6%.
이대로 그냥 100년을 방치하면 우리 인간은 살아남을 수 없다는 게 확실합니다.
Korea is the 10th largest consumer of oil and the 10th biggest producer of carbon emissions. This is our nation's reality. Are we ready to survive amid climate change?
자체를 친환경적으로 바꾸는 노력이 선행되지 않는다라면은 지속 가능한 미래를 좀 장담할 수 없는 상황이라고 볼 수가 있습니다.
What must we do to save the planet? The answer lies within our lives. The American Museum of Natural History held a climate change exhibit in Seoul last year. Visitors were able to see how climate change is wreaking havoc on the planet's ecosystem. As the ice in the North and South Poles melt at a faster rate, polar bears are on the verge of extinction due to vanishing ice. The rising temperature of ocean waters has resulted in the destruction of more than 60% of the world's coral reefs, a vital habitat for sea creatures. Now climate change is a threat to humanity. More than 300,000 lives were lost in hurricanes and floods. An increase of just 1 degree in the world's average temperature had devastating consequences. This exhibit drove home the message for many that our planet is in danger.
정말 당장 지금 눈앞에 닥친 걸 미리 실감을 할 수 있는 것 같아요.
기후가 한 1도 정도밖에 안 올라가는데 이렇게 심각한 일이 일어난다는 거 보니까 좀 충격이 됐어요.
What will happen to the Korean Peninsula 30 years from now if seawater levels rise by 1 meter? The bridges over the Han River will be destroyed and high-rise buildings will be in ruins. The city of Seoul will turn into a wasteland. It would be a nightmarish situation in which only a few survivors live in a city submerged in water. But this could become a reality in the not-so-distant future.
지난 20세기 100년 동안에 지구 전체의 기온은 0.75도가 상승했습니다. 근데 우리나라는 거기에 배인 1.5도가 올라갔어요. 근데 서울은 그보다 더 높은 3도가 상승했습니다.
What must be done to combat climate change and create a sustainable future for mankind? There is no time to hesitate. We must act now and prepare for the future.
우리나라가 세계에서 가장 인구 밀도가 높고 또 에너지가 거의 생산되지 않는 나라이기 때문에 이제는 그러한 라이프스타일로 바뀌는 것이 지구도 살리고
그 생활 패턴들을 다 바꾸는 게 그 결국은 이제 환경을 이제 지속 가능 소비로 갈 수 있는
우리의 생활 자체가 전부가 환경 문제와 직결되어 있기 때문에요.
Creating a sustainable coexistence between humans and the environment is the only option that can save humans from this looming crisis. A revolution is underway around the world to change destructive ways of life. This children's clothing store in Frankfurt, Germany has recently been attracting more customers. When you enter, you won't notice anything very different, but the store has a unique selling point.
Naja, die meisten Kunden, die halten sich schon immer mehr vorne beim Recyclingbereich auf.
Ja, es kommt drauf an. Also es gibt Kunden, die natürlich, also die sind halt auch ein sozialer Laden, sage ich jetzt mal. Es gibt für Kunden, die viele Kinder haben, steht der Secondhand-Bereich halt offen. Und ne, für, wenn sie natürlich etwas weniger Geld haben, finden sie hier etwas. Und für Kunden, die halt besondere Geschenke suchen, natürlich auch besondere Sachen. Ja, es ist für beides was da.
The special deals are products made from used materials. The store's designer eagerly shows how she creates new clothes from a used shirt.
Ein kleines Hängerchen, ein kleines Kleid.
She tells us she can easily make kids' clothes from discarded garments. In just 5 minutes, she makes a pretty vest from a drab sweater. Ecomel sells clothes that are reincarnated from old clothes.
Gerade bei Kindern, die vielleicht ein halbes Jahr passen und danach eigentlich, weil sie keine Geschwister mehr haben und keine Bekannten, wo sie es weitergeben können, dann einfach vielleicht wegschmeißen oder auch in einen Second-Hand-Laden geben, dass die dieses Bewusstsein halt entwickeln, Mensch, ein halbes Jahr habe ich ein Textil und das kann ich doch eigentlich auch gebraucht kaufen. Ich muss es gar nicht neu kaufen, es ist erstens günstiger, es wird mehrmals verwendet, also jetzt gerade im Second-Hand-Bereich, das macht Sinn. Also für viele. Also es gibt da so ein Umdenken. Also das ist schon, das passiert gerade in Deutschland.
Malin opened his Ecomel store 2 years ago and he's seen how consumer habits have changed. His store attracts more customers than ever before.
Ja, davon, also ich habe davon gehört, ja. Ich habe jetzt kein angelesenes, fundiertes Wissen, aber genau, das habe ich so gehört, dass das Recycling Stoffe sind und selbstgemachte oder in irgendeiner Form jedenfalls sehr individuell gefertigt, ja. Mhm. Ja, toll.
Sachen hier.
Gefällt uns gut. Deswegen sind wir auch immer wieder da, weil es einfach was anderes ist, als was man so von der Stange sonst kauft, natürlich.
Ja.
Another factor is the growing perception that refurbished products contain less harmful chemicals and are thus safer for little children.
Am Kopf umfangen.
Ja.
Und es ist natürlich auch schön zu sehen, dass das Ganze immer mehr Erfolg hat, also dass Wachstum da ist. Auch jetzt in den schlechten Zeiten, sage ich mal, was die Weltwirtschaftskrise anbetrifft. Wir sind zwar lokal hier tätig und kriegen davon eigentlich gar nichts mit. Wir haben jedes Jahr ein Umsatzwachstum von 20%.
An exhibition called Fashion with Morals was held at this art museum in Gyeonggi-do in Korea.
종이 아닌 것 같아.
맞아. 종이로 만들어가지고 테이프로 만들었잖아.
붙였다고?
어.
아니야.
맞아.
The exhibits that drew the most attention were clothes made from recycled materials. Trash had been reincarnated into magnificent clothes and fashion accessories. British designer Mark Liu created these dazzling and mesmerizing clothes. From a colorful dress made from the sleeves of used shirts to a fluffy dress made from newspapers. There's also a dress made entirely from magazines. Mark Liu has his own brand called Waste Zero and is a leading British designer who uses recycled materials. At first, this sparkling dress looks like it's made from soft fabrics. But a closer look will reveal that it's made of pull tabs. These creative designs were made by visionary designer Gary Harvey. His dresses are sold at high prices in Europe. These eco-friendly fashion designers are making an impact on the fashion industry, which fuels consumption with new seasonal collections.
그냥 개인적으로 소유하는 개념의 자원이 아닌 모두가 함께 그리고 세대를 지나서도 공유해야 하는 부분들이기 때문에 재활용을 하는 디자인 혹은 재활용한 어떤 재료를 사용하는 여러 가지 형태의 활용들이 또 그런 맥락에서 다 같이 좀 확산되어서 실천이 되고 있는 게 아닌가 싶습니다.
In a vacant lot near residential homes in Gorakdong, the neighbors grow vegetables here, and so does Mrs. Nam Hee Jung. From lettuce to tomatoes, she grows all kinds of vegetables.
농약이나 비료 이런 거를 안 치고 기르니까 나는 뭐 가족이 건강하고요. 그리고 뭐 또 집에서 흔히 먹을 수 있는 그런 야채류들은 거의 다 길러서 먹게 되니까 생활비도 덜 들고.
She enjoys coming to this garden every day, tending to her vegetables.
자. 올해 수확은 좋나요?
예, 뭐 제가 한 거에 비해서 땅이 훨씬 더 많은 것을 주는 것 같아요. 저는 조금밖에 그냥 씨만 심어놨는데 그냥 저절로 자랐어요. 자연이 키워줬어요.
Although her organic garden does not look special, it is full of nutritious vegetables. Her garden grows with help from natural sunlight and nutrients in the soil.
She is careful about what she buys when she shops for fresh produce she doesn't grow herself. She only buys locally grown produce. 농약을 많이 친 것도 그렇지만 일단은 수입을 많이 사용하게 되면 우리 농민들이 농사를 짓지를 못하시기 때문에
She also chooses eco-friendly methods when preparing food.
음식의 그런 고유한 맛을 알 것 같아요. 전에는 그걸 잘 몰랐거든요. 그래서 항상 이렇게 뭐 무쳐 먹거나 볶아 먹거나 이랬었는데 요즘에는 이제 주로 이렇게 날 걸로 많이 먹어요.
She uses minimum energy to cook her food and eats most of her vegetables raw. Her meals are healthy and prepared in a natural way. 미세스 남 grows her own vegetables, but when she buys fresh produce, she chooses a locally grown variety. This is the kind of lifestyle change we need to make.
우리 생활 체제는 대량 생산과 대량 소비에 익숙한 체제가 되었습니다. 하지만 이제는 자연 자원을 이제 이용하는 것이 아니고 우리가 같이 가기 위해서는 소규모로 생산하고 소규모로 소비하는 좀 착한 소비 시대가 와야 된다고 보고 있고요.
Greve in Chianti is a small town in the heart of Italy. Agriculture is the main industry in this village, and locals have pursued small-scale production using traditional methods for the last 10 years. Most of the produce in Chianti is grown with traditional farming techniques. Livestock is also raised the traditional way. It's common to see a herd of goats crossing the road. Most of the livestock graze freely in open spaces.
Quindi, ovviamente, in una carne più ricca di fibra e non di acqua, abbiamo dei grossi vantaggi qualitativi, non economici però, purtroppo, perché diciamo che 10 mesi 150 kg in stalla, 18 mesi 150 kg in bosco.
The motto in Greve in Chianti is to produce safe and excellent agricultural products. And that motto also applies to food processing. Marco used to work day and night as a lighting technician in the city for 10 years. He moved to this village after becoming weary of fast-paced city life. He also found a new life purpose after coming here. Cheese making is his newfound passion.
Uno dei formaggi che facciamo che piace di più e che si vende meglio è il caprino fresco, che appunto è un caprino di tre giorni, quindi un formaggio freschissimo che vede appena un pochino di sale così. E abbiamo partecipato a un concorso di formaggi di capra e abbiamo vinto questo premio per il nostro formaggio fresco. È una cosa che ci ha fatto molto piacere. Ecco, questa è una tagliata di 24 ore. Dopo 24 ore la mettiamo in forma così.
He makes all of the cheese by hand and does not rely on any mechanical processes.
Allora, slow è una parola che si usa molto, bio è una parola che si usa molto. Poi bisogna vedere cosa c'è dietro, no? Perché dietro sono bellissime parole, però poi dietro deve esserci anche qualche cosa di vero, no? Perché sennò è solo una moda. Magari per questi anni va bene slow, poi forse fra tre anni sarà di moda un'altra cosa. Però l'importante è che sono parole bellissime, sono parole dove secondo me tutti bisogna andare in questa direzione, perché il mondo, per cambiare un pochino il mondo, no? Per farlo ritornare un pochino più vivibile.
Marco considers organic farming essential for protecting the future of the next generation. There is a place that has followed traditional ways for centuries. This factory makes handmade prosciutto and salami. The handmade ham produced here is exported to 10 countries. But 10 years ago, the factory was on the brink of bankruptcy because automated meat processing factories were undercutting them. The factory only recovered after Chianti was designated as a slow city. Its meat production has increased 150-fold. Paolini hams are handmade. Stefano is the eighth generation to inherit his family's 300-year-old meat business. He employs 10 workers, but still works on the factory floor.
Non lo fa più nessuno, costa dei soldi, costa molti soldi, però, e poi non tutti riescono a fare delle cose buone, capito? Ci sono tanti che lavorano, anche piccoli produttori, ma che non riescono a fare delle cose buone. Mia nonna, sai cos'è mia nonna? La mamma della mamma, mia nonna, mi diceva: noi si fa quel che si sa, ma si sa quel che si fa. Se non si sa quello che si fa, come si fa a fare la roba?
That is why he has stubbornly followed traditional methods. The Zero Energy House was built in Saldung, Gangwon-do in Korea in the spring of 2009. Mr. Lee Dae-chul designed and built this home all by himself. He gets several visitors a day. More than 4,000 people have visited this home in the last year. It's a revelation for them to see a house that uses a heating and cooling system that does not rely on fossil fuels. Although it was 30 degrees Celsius outside, the rooms were quite cool.
떠들고 발이 시려가지고 춥고 오히려 잘 추워요.
겨울에는 따뜻함을 하는 난로의 역할이고
난로 역할.
겨울에 여름에는 이게 에어컨 역할.
Befitting its name, the house uses zero energy. But how does the house stay warm in the winter and cool in the summer without using any energy?
집안에 들어오는 에너지를 하나라도 내보내지 말자는 전제하에 집을 지은 거예요. 이 집은. 그러니까 이 집은 심하게 얘기하면 이제 보온병이라고 볼 수가 있죠.
Glass windows are on the side of the house that faces south. This brings in more sunlight. The large windows have wood curtains to trap heat in the winter. The use of heavy insulation can decrease airflow in the house, so a heat recovery air circulation device was installed. An air pipe is installed in the ground where it is heated by geothermal energy. And then resurfaces into the home. Meanwhile, another pipe is designed to extract air from the home.
나빠진 공기를 빨아들여서 밖으로 내보내고 그 내보낼 때 열을 회수해서 들어오는 공기에다 그걸 넣어주기 때문에 그 공기 교환으로 인한 그 열 손실이 최소한으로 만드는 거죠.
Using geothermal energy to power an air circulation system creates a home that is warm in the winter and cool in the summer without burning fossil fuels. We visited Mr. Yi's home 4 months later in early winter. 인 강원 프로빈스 살둔 빌리지 is known for its harsh cold winters. Though winter has not begun in other parts of the country, the temperature here has already fallen to -8°C. But how warm is it inside the home? The room temperature stands at 22.3°C. The only heater in the home is a fireplace. It looks like an ordinary fireplace, but it can provide heat for more than 36 hours in one session.
이 집에 그러니까 유일한 그 난방 장치는 이 배치카뿐입니다. 이 배치카는 그 원산지가 이제 북유럽이나 소련인데요. 그 설계 도면을 갖다가 그 구해가지고 이제 우리 한국식에 맞게 한국식 중에 맞게 많이 손을 봤어요.
Mr. Yi has a BA in forestry and also worked as a park official. He began to take an interest in energy-saving practices 10 years ago. He worried the nation would face an energy crisis unless it changed its energy consumption habits. So he began studying energy-saving techniques. He collected material related to energy efficiency on his trips abroad and read more than 1,000 books on the subject.
할 수 있는 일이 뭐가 있나 그래서 생각을 했더니 이제 주택이라는 결론이 나와가지고요. 또 마침 저의 계획이 저희 살던 마을에 와서 집을 짓고 살라고 그랬기 때문에 6년 전부터 이제 이런 제로에너지 하우스 에너지를 전혀 쓰지 않는 집을 관심을 갖고 자료를 모으기 시작했는데요.
With no background in architecture, Mr. Yi built his house through trial and error. He devoted 6 years to building a zero-energy house suitable for Korea's climate. Knowing that changing our dwelling places is the only way to overcome a looming energy crisis, Mr. Yi focused on the idea of building a house that minimally impacts nature and relies on clean energy sources. Darmstadt is about an hour's drive from Frankfurt. This is where the K6 eco-friendly residential housing is located. The passive house movement began in Germany, Today, there are more than 5,000 passive homes in the country like the Kasich's houses. More than 90 families live in the Kasich's complex, but it is just one section of the massive passive complex that will be completed in 5 years.
Guten Morgen.
Hallo. Kommen Sie rein. Hallo. Hallo.
Julian's family moved to the Kasich's complex in 2007 and have already spent 2 summers and 1 winter in their new home.
Nein, wollen wir nicht. Komisch, weil man ja sonst früher im Winter immer dicke Pullis und jetzt kann ich auch im Winter mit kurzer Arm laufen im Haus.
The room temperature stays constantly between 23 and 24 degrees Celsius in any season. And room humidity is managed naturally at levels of 55%.
Heizkosten haben wir nicht. Dadurch, dass wir die Lüftungsanlage haben, haben wir etwas höhere Stromkosten, weil die Lüftungsanlage mit Strom läuft.
The family likes that they save money on heating, but what they like even more is that their son catches fewer colds since living here.
Oft ist ja in alten Wohnungen, die vielleicht 100 Jahre alt sind, ist ja immer so, dass es am Boden zieht, an den Füßen kalt und Babys krabbeln viel. Und hier ist an der Decke wie unten warm. Also für Babys ist es ganz gut. Oh je.
These advantages make the passive house popular among young families in Germany. Georg Chilga, an architect, was one of the designers of the Kasich's complex. He designed 25 of the 50 houses in the Kasich's complex.
Dann muss ich natürlich von Anfang an schon im Kopf haben, wo kommt Lüftung und wo kommt Abwasser hin. Das sind die zwei Hauptsachen, die durchs ganze Haus gehen.
These pipes within the house circulate the air in addition to heating and cooling the rooms.
Hier ist unser Technikraum. Das ist die Lüftungsanlage, die ist jetzt im Moment auch in Betrieb. Wir sehen hier, die ist stark wärmegedämmt, damit es kein Kondensat von der warmen Raumluft am kalten Rohr gibt, wenn die jetzt im Winter eben kalte Luft reinbringt. Hier sind dann die zwei Rohre, die die Luft versorgen im Haus. Das ist die Zuluft, die alle Räume versorgt mit frischer Luft.
The passive house must be well insulated to be energy efficient. That is why the air circulation system is the most important component of the house.
Also es ist besonders gut gedämmt und wir haben hier eigentlich fast nur aus Holz. Also das ganze Gerüst hier ist aus Holz. Selbst hier nur ganz unten in der Kellerfußboden ist kein Holz. Sonst ist hier so ziemlich alles Holz.
Germany's passive house is made with special wood that prevents energy loss and reduces its energy usage by 10% compared to an ordinary home.
Das heißt zum Beispiel, Korea hat keine eigenen Ölvorkommen und da ist natürlich dann auch die Möglichkeit, dass man unabhängig vom Öl wird. Die Prognose ist, dass wir in den nächsten 5 Jahren mindestens 35% aller Häuser in Passivhausstandard bauen werden.
Germans are using energy-efficient methods to make smarter homes. Europeans have taken a different approach to designing homes that will produce energy instead of consuming it. Being resource poor, Germany has taken steps to prepare for a future of dwindling energy supplies.
Ja, wenn ich die Energie nicht in die Luft blase, dann hat es natürlich für die Umwelt was zu tun. Und wir müssen uns auch um die Umwelt kümmern. Wir zerstören unsere eigene Zukunft, die Zukunft unserer Kinder.
Germans are known to be environmentally conscious. We visited one recycling center operated by the city of Frankfurt. Many trucks come by this center every day. The trucks unload discarded household and office items that were collected in Frankfurt. The items range from home appliances to furniture and much more. These disposed of household items and office equipment are processed in the recycling center. This particular factory in the center mainly deals with household appliances. The technicians will inspect all the appliances and see if they can be repaired.
Dann wurde hier neben repariert oder wenigstens gecheckt, ob es funktioniert, ob ist alles in Ordnung. Und falls nicht, wird repariert und hier eingelagert. Und dann, wenn jemand kaufen will, kauft und wir schicken per Post.
Some of the discarded home appliances were manufactured decades ago.
Aber das ist sehr schwierig, weil es sind teilweise Bauteile, die gar nicht mehr produziert werden. Das ist relativ schwierig.
The center can sell such repaired audio equipment at a high price to audiophiles.
Das ist jetzt auch kein Spitzengerät. Es gibt Geräte, die sind auch sehr alt und die sind wunderschön, ja, also vom Klang her und so. Und die sind dann, da kann man dann schon teilweise 300 oder 400 Euro verlangen. Also das ist dann relativ
After a product is repaired, it is priced based on its value and features. These appliances are much cheaper than brand new items and work just fine. Many thrifty consumers shop for refurbished products here. However, some equipment is beyond repair and has to be disposed of. These types of items are disassembled by hand. And the workable parts are sold over the internet or by phone. The center strips down equipment to its bare parts because this work can reduce the waste that goes into landfills.
Die Restabfälle, die nach und nach der Behandlung unserer Anlage übrig sind, machen etwa 3 bis 5 Gewichtsprozent der Gesamtmenge aus. Der Restmüll geht in eine Abfallbehandlungsanlage, in eine Müllverbrennungsanlage oder in eine Deponierung, wie es für die Restabfälle in Deutschland eben vorgesehen ist.
Frankfurt established large recycling centers like the Recycling Zentrum in 2003 to reduce the waste that goes into landfills. The city generates a profit from running the Recycling Zentrum, which posts annual profits of about 4.5 million euros a year. It's the largest recycling center in Germany in terms of profits generated and size.
Aber das sollte überall, in ganzen Ländern sollte sein. Das wäre gut. Dann würden die Menschen auch dann ihren Wert verstehen, was wir dann haben. Nicht immer neue Sachen kaufen, man kann auch die alten Sachen wieder verwenden. Optimal.
This shopping mall is located on the outskirts of Frankfurt. It's called Neufundland, which means a newly discovered land. The large mall has more than 3,500 square feet of retail space and sells everything from furniture to home appliances. The store also sells dishware, like a typical mall. But every item sold here was originally discarded. So the store uses processes to refurbish items.
Ja, dann mit dem Rechner wird bewertet, mit dem Warenwirtschaftssystem durchgeschaut, dann kommt die Artikelkarte dran, Endkontrolle und es geht immer weiter. Es kommt da rein und da raus. Also es wandert ständig alles. Dadurch haben wir immer Bewegung drin. Welche VV fangen wir schon auf dem Fall, ne? Gut. Schauen wir mal.
The size, condition and type of material used in every item are carefully checked. After this information is entered into the database, the program analyzes its quality. The computer will determine a reasonable price for the used item.
Da fehlt noch die Kleiderstange, die muss noch reingebaut werden. Da fehlen noch ein paar Fachböden. Das muss alles erst gemacht werden. Deswegen steht der hier. Er muss noch gebaut werden und dann kann erst bewertet werden.
At first glance, the wardrobe closet looks like it's in good condition. But it won't be put on sale until it's inspected and refurbished.
Das zum Beispiel, das war eine alte Nähmaschine. Sah so ähnlich aus wie die da drüben. Und da hat uns eine Firma, die hat uns in Handarbeit gemacht. Also das ist auch gemeint. Ich glaube, weiß gestrichen, Farbe, 10 Farben übereinander. Die haben dann neue Teile eingesetzt. Das ist neu, das Stück, das ist neu. Hier an der Seite, komplett abgeschliffen. Jedes Teil, jede Ecke mit der Hand. Und es sieht richtig schön aus.
This piece of furniture is priced at 583 €. It's relatively cheap for an antique. The store offers delivery and customer services like a typical retailer. And this is what attracts new and repeat customers to Newfoundland. Mr. Moritz is a regular customer at Newfoundland because he needs to buy lots of furniture for his big family.
Das ist schon alte und die Marmor ist sehr sauber, ganz keine Fehler und gefällt mich.
Mr. Moritz settles on a marble table priced at 62 €. Offering good quality furniture at low prices, the store has steadily attracted new customers since it was founded in 2003. Then what do Germans think about buying refurbished goods?
Wegen die alte, das ist stabile Material. Neu ist sehr schwach, aber ich interessiere mich immer an die Antike und alte Möbel.
Ja, aber ich denke, hier ist es vielleicht auch ein bisschen günstiger und die Auswahl ist ja auch sehr groß und man muss, und das sind alles neue Artikel, aber manchmal findet man auch so gebrauchte Sachen, die noch so toll sind und da kann man die auch kaufen. Mhm. Muss man nicht alles wegwerfen.
Ja, klar. So viel fortgebracht.
Ja, es wird leider Gottes viel zu viel weggetan.
Germany recycles 65% of the waste it produces. It was able to become a leading nation in recycling waste because its people are not profligate consumers. It is also socially acceptable to buy refurbished goods there. $57 million can be saved by recycling a mere 1% of that trash. But perceptions about trash must first be changed. These designers hit the streets to change the way people perceive trash. They're Evi and Karen. They go out to collect trash once a month.
Great. Let's see what you could do with
that. That'd be a nice like scarf holder thing. You could hang that on the back of your closet.
Yeah, this would be like those hanging, like those shelves that hang your shoes.
Mm-hmm.
Because at Replay Ground, we believe that garbage has feelings too.
Should we put storage?
Yeah. If you just Sometimes we do, but we recognize that our studio is only so large and there's so much garbage and we get kind of overwhelmed with it. And also because Free Playground's about education, so we want to teach people to do this themselves.
They chose to collect trash every third Tuesday of the month. While looking through garbage, they'll also make people aware that trash can be useful.
So we found some treasures over here also. We found this really great glass jar. Glass jars are great for a lot of things. They're pretty valuable for storing all sorts of art supplies or some grains, any kind of food.
They'll jot down any ideas that come to mind and share them with their colleagues. Trash collecting day is also when they share with others the value they discover in piles of trash. They're collecting trash as usual to make people aware of its hidden value. They'll continue to go through garbage bags around the streets. A worldwide movement is spreading to change the way we consume, travel, eat, and work. Women are playing a central role in pushing for these changes.
기본적인 의식주, 또 소비 생활, 그다음에 여가 생활 이런 것들이 결국 가정이라는 것을 단위로 해서 시작을 하기 때문에 그런 부분에서 주도적으로 하는 분들이 이제 여성이고
가정에서 절대적인 영향력을 갖고 있는 어머님들이 에코맘으로 이제 전환하셔가지고 친환경적인 생활 습관을 만드시는 것 자체는 우리 사회 전체가 환경적으로 친환경적인 생활 그 사회로 바뀌어 가는데 아주 기본 토대가 되는 방안이라고 생각을 하고 있습니다.
Eco-mom combines the word mom with the word that stands for the environment, eco. The Eco-mom Alliance is the largest of these groups in the United States. We visited a family home in Rybrook, New York, where the mother is a member of the organization.
Hello, you're
hi.
Hi, girl.
Yes,
how are you?
Hi.
Nice to meet you.
Hi.
My name is Heather.
Yeah.
Oh, gosh,
that hurt. Amanda is the mother of four children and a full-time homemaker. She shows a local newspaper clipping about her children, who were praised for picking up litter around the neighborhood.
We're just picking up plastic bottles and gloves and whatever we find on the beach and so.
Oh, look at you smiling.
Olivia is interested in reducing trash and landfills due to her mother's influence.
Come and look at this.
Mostly teaching, I guess, with actions, not really preaching it, but just in terms of how I shop or recycle, things like that. The children definitely see what mom and dad are doing. So I guess that's sort of teaching all day in little ways.
I wanted to say that when the TV's on and nobody's watching the TV, and then when you want to go do somewhere else, you have to remember to turn it off.
And you can make your shower shorter.
And you can plant more trees and plant bushes and plant plants and to help the environment.
Make a garden.
Yeah.
And water.
Wow.
and remember to water and take care of it.
An estimated 72 million pounds of carbon dioxide emissions have been saved due to participation in the Eco-Mom Challenge. And the health of over 36,000 families has been directly improved due to changes Eco-Moms have made.
Wow.
And I just think if we can, you know, all come together as a group, we can just keep making wonderful change.
I'll plant these with paper.
The members also pressure companies to manufacture eco-friendly products while using ethical practices.
They'll have things on eco-friendly. So here's Kimberly. Just fun. I'll show you a quick little. Have you seen any of these?
Actually, she is in Los Angeles, right?
One project Eco-Mom Alliance members are engaged in is boycotting products made by workers in the Congo who work under unfair labor conditions.
empower you to help stop climate change.
The minerals that make up the cell phones, laptops, and a lot of these minerals are from the Congo, and there's been a huge war, and these poor women are, you know, being raped, and it's just a horrible thing that's going on. So I personally contacted my cell phone provider, Apple, whatever, to make sure that these minerals that are found in the Congo are not being used in my life.
Not only does the group use their extensive member network in America to boycott products that harm the environment, but they also actively promote eco-friendly products. Representing consumers, they have a powerful voice in American society.
I think we're helping each other out. They're helping us, we're helping them to spread the good word.
You know, wooden blocks, a lot of these old...
People like Amanda are mobilizing others to push companies to change.
This guy.
Wow, what is that for?
Eco-ver.
And speak up, stand up, vote, you know, elect officials that, you know, believe in the right thing. So I think we moms can make a big change. We're a powerful force, and I think, you know, our baby steps are going to go a long way.
Small changes made in homes can change the future of Earth. These mothers have made lifestyle changes to give their children a better future. They are indeed protectors of the environment.
지역 농산물을 많이 사용하는 편이고 되도록이면 마트를 가더라도 유기농 농산물이니 그런 인증 마크가 들어있는 걸 그리고 뒤에 아이들 간식 같은 거 특히나 아이들 뭐 과자 같은 것도 이렇게 뒤에 성분표 뭐 그런 거 더 꼼꼼히 보는 것 같아요.
어렸을 적에는 그 노을도 보이고요. 그 저녁에 학교 갔다 오면은 그 저녁 노을이 쫙 있는 게 너무 아름다웠어요. 근데 어느 순간 그런 게 없어졌잖아요. 그런 거가 저는 참 가슴이 많이 아프더라고요. 안타깝고 아이들한테 그 뭐 아름다운 모습을 보여줄 수 없겠다라고 생각하니까 너무 이렇게 안타까운 거예요.
공해나 여러 가지 현대인의 뭐 식습관이나 그래서 가능하면 먹는 거, 입는 거 이렇게 그 친환경 쪽으로 굉장히 신경 많이 쓰고 있습니다.
Changing the type of clothing we wear, our workplace, living spaces, and even the kinds of food we eat. Minor changes can go a long way in combating global warming. Is our society ready to embrace change?